Now today we will discuss about healing. So inflammation is destruction predominantly. Chronic inflammation is also healing, but acute inflammation will cause destruction. Chronic inflammation will cause part destruction, part new tissue development. And finally, healing is that whenever healing is the by definition. Is the process of restoration of lost injured tissue. How it can be accomplished? It can be accomplished by two pathways, either regeneration or repair. Is regeneration. Regeneration is when there will be restoration of the same type of cells at the site of injured cell. Classic example, we see the tail of the lizard. You see that whenever it will fall, it will again grow. Alas, if you have that thing, then after amputation, our foot will also go grow. So regeneration is the power which is predominantly seen in the lower mammals and lower invertebrates. Also in invertebrates. But we have less regenerative property in our body. But still there is possibility of limited regeneration in our body. So before going to regeneration, we must think about the types of cells in our body. This is according to the rate of cell division. According to the rate of cell division, our cells can be divided into three broad groups. The one is the labile cells. So labile cells means they are continuously dividing cells, like our skin cells. Whenever we are losing the skin and then again it is going on. Like our gastrointestinal tract cells, they are always changing. Whenever you are using a scrubber, you are just taking out the dead cells from the skin. But you no longer see any bleach in your skin, so your skin has already replaced them. These labile cells, they have retained the power of regeneration, definitely. So, whenever there will be only skin injury, then maybe superficial skin injury, then there will be after few weeks or maximum 1 week, you will see that there is complete restoration of the skin. There will be no other abnormality in the skin. So, that is called regenerative labile cells. Next. The extreme end is the permanent cell. So those cells are the brain cells and the skeletal muscle cells. They are losing the power of cell division. So there is absolutely no regeneration is possible. Whenever any brain tissue loss. So with age we are losing this thing, and you are much more intelligent than us because you have new energetic brain. And a lot of brain cells in our cerebellum and cerebrum has already died, and there is no question of replacing that because regeneration is not possible in the brain. Then there is some cells which are present in between. So these cells, they normally do not divide. But when you give appropriate stimulus, then they will start dividing. Somebody is always stay inside the home, but whenever his or her home catches fire, then he or she will come out from the home. It is like this. The liver cells, the kidney parenchymal cells, They normally do not divide, remain stable. But whenever there will be any injury to the liver, approximately even if the 80 to 90% of the liver tissue, if it is destroyed, then there will be, if the architecture is maintained, then there will be complete regeneration. So in appropriate time, the surviving cells will start dividing and will ultimately cause complete regeneration. So in that case, there will be the regeneration by the liver parenchymal cells. So there will be no question of fibrosis. So this is regeneration, and in any healing, there will be usually both regeneration as well as repair. Let us see what is repair. Repair is a process when the lost tissue is restored by fibrosis. So there will be fibrous tissue, and so the parenchymal cells are lost. There may be some functional loss, but there will be no change in the, at least the anatomical contour. And whenever you have a deep injury over your head or leg or anywhere, then sometimes there will be a deep mark, and that mark is always different from the architecture, color, everything is different from the normal skin. So that is the scar formation. As there is considerable tissue loss, so the body cannot regenerate fully, but instead of regeneration, there is some repair, and that will come as a depressed area and slightly discolored area and or deeply colored area. Both can be possible. So that is known as a scar tissue. So repair is healing by fibrosis. Regeneration is healing by restoration of parenchymal cells. Now we are thinking about the healing of skin, because that is very much important in our surgical practice. In surgical practice, whenever you go to the ward, you will see that there is always cuts and you have to do stitches. Whenever you go to OP, you will see there is a lot of cuts, and those cuts have to be healed. So you must know the basic pathophysiology of healing of the wounds. Okay. Before going into the healing of cutaneous wound, we must have a general idea about repair as a whole. So in our body, whenever there will be injury, what thing will occur? There will be first cellular infiltration. Whenever there will be injury, there will be hemorrhage, and there will be also acute inflammatory cell infiltration. And after 1 to 2 days, there will be chronic inflammation. And the chronic cells as well as the acute cells will engulf the cell debris, the blood, etc., and will clear it up. Then what thing will happen? So first there will be cellular infiltration. Now think about a local area where there is injury. Then what thing will happen? There will be neovascularization. You have to supply, because the blood supply is already lost. So you have to supply new blood vessels to that area. Unless you supply new blood vessels, then the repair work will not be possible. So neovascularization is a process by which new blood vessels are formed from already existing vessels. Now think about the dotted area. Suppose in this part there is an injury. So in this part, the blood vessels are lost, but there will be presence of blood vessels on both sides, on all sides. So all my blood vessels are present on the both sides. Now from each side, there will be prolongation of endothelial parts. So endothelial buds will come. The numerous endothelial buds will come from both sides, and in the center they will join together. And after joining together, then there will be canalization. So there will become an opening. So now, so there will be formation of a complete line through which blood will pass. Now blood cells will come. Now the fibrous tissue will come. The fibrous tissue will lay collagen in order to keep them support. So there will be formation of a complete blood vessels, and then there will be also the collagen will go on maturing, and there will be formation of a scar tissue. So the stages of any healing is, first is the infiltration of the cells, then there will be angiogenesis, then there will be fibrous tissue deposition, and also fibrous tissue infiltration and collagen deposition, and for lastly remodeling of the collagen. Now, so in the acute inflammation, in healing, you will see a stage where there will be multiple blood vessels. Along with presence of acute as well as chronic inflammatory cells. There will be edema. Why edema? Newly formed blood vessels are leaky because their wall is not very much well formed. So the water will pass through it. So it will become edema. Edema, how you can understand? The cellular structures will be wide apart. So this is wide apart, and there will be fibrous tissue. So you see at the site of injury, there will be proliferation of the blood vessels, there will be presence of inflammatory cells, there will be tissue edema, and there will be presence of fibrous tissue. This combination is known as granulation tissue. So never confuse it with granuloma. Granuloma is a feature of chronic inflammation special type, where there will be circumscribed local collection of epithelioid cells. Whereas a granulation tissue is always occurring as a result of injury, where there will be newly formed leaky blood vessels, edema, fibrous tissue, and so the stroma will be loose, and there will be inflammatory cell infection. And you have seen granulation tissue. Have you seen? Have not? So whenever there will be any skin injury or anywhere in the injury, after 2 to 3 days, you will see that it will become very much red, angry looking, and its surface is granular. You have not seen this thing? So that is the granulation tissue. If you touch it, it will bleed. This granularity comes from the newly formed blood vessels. So granulation tissue is must for any condition of the healing. Okay, so this is the standard. Now we are coming into the cutaneous wounds. So cutaneous wounds can be of two types. One, which are done in the OT, and another which had done in the road in a road traffic accident. Or simply, one is a train cart surgical wound, can be possible also during accident. Suppose a glass knife or any knife, sharp knife or a glass, there can be a clean cut. Or a crushed injury, whenever there will be tissue loss, as may occur in a road traffic accident. So first one, the healing is called healing by first intention. And in the second case, it is known as healing by second intention. Healing by first intention we will discuss first. And in healing by second intention, we will only discuss the differences. So first intention. So this part is the skin. So there is an injury directly which is destroying the skin epithelium, squamous epithelium, and going deeper. So what will occur in the first step? It will fill with blood. So it is our common idea that blood clot will form and that will seal the bleeding site. So that bacteria will not enter. Everything is important. Bacteria will not get entered through that injured site. So there is a blood clot. Now what else will come? Whenever there will be any problem anywhere, you will see that first the small flies, you call the small dadas of the local site, will come. Hey, what is the matter? What is the matter? What is the matter? They are numerous. They are the neutrophils. So first will come the neutrophils. So they will reach, they will engulf the tissue, but within 1 to 2 days they will realize that they may not complete the same thing. So they will ask for the senior dadas of para. So the senior dadas, that is the macrophages, will come after 2-3 days. So first 24 hour bleeding, acute inflammation. Then 48 to 72 hours macrophages will come. And once macrophages will come, macrophages will not only engulf, they will also send stimulation for angiogenesis. So now new blood vessels will be formed. And once new blood vessels are formed, there will be formation of a granulation tissue. And that will occur in 3 to 5 days. And you will see in the surface, there is an angry looking substance which is covered by the dried blood, which is known as scab. Thank you. Upore ei mamri pore ena tule dikhi bhito pe dekhi bhito sanshe bil korte hanu pore bhai. The upper part is the scab, which occurs as a result of drying of the blood, and that acts as a protective cover. Below this thing, there will be formation of the granulation tissue. And then fibrous tissue will come. And fibrous tissue will lay collagen. So ultimately, the lower part will be repaired. But what about the skin? Actual epithelial lining. Whenever there will be injury, within the first 24 hours, the epithelial cut end will start proliferating from both the ends. So they will come down, they will divide the blood into upper scab and lower part of the blood and will join in the center. So ultimately they will cover the whole granulation tissue which is present below and the scab will fall. So if you do not remove the scab after 4 to 7 days, it will automatically fall. And then you see the lower part is not so much healthy, because already in the granulation tissue, the fibrous tissue laying is started. So it becomes less muscular. And the granulation, there will be the blood vessels will also become less leaky. So when you start with tissue injury, there will be beginning of the inflammatory cell infiltration in the 24 hours. During again in the 24 hours, there will be also epidermal prolongation. that epidermal prolongation will join together in the middle, and the upper part of the blood will turn into a scab. The lower part of the blood are taken by the neutrophils, but neutrophils are inadequate to take, so they ask for the macrophages. The macrophages have come by 48 to 72 hours. They are the senior cells, so they will take much more time, and they move at a slower pace, not rate. So they will come in 48 to 72 hours. They will clear off the total debris, total cell injury, and also the blood vessels. But they will also ask for angiogenesis. So there will be new blood vessel formation, and there will be, with new blood vessel formation, there will be fibrous tissue deposition. So ultimately, the lower part of the skin is restored by the proliferation of the skin itself. So what do you call it? It's regeneration. But the lower part is restored by the stimulation of the fibrous tissue. So what do you call it? Repair. So ultimately, our first intention is a combination of repair as well as regeneration. The upper part will regenerate, the lower part will show scar tissue formation, that is, there will be repair. So in this way, a healing by first intention is completed. During healing by second intention, much more amount of tissue is lost. So what will be the difference? The basic pathogenesis is the same. The first is, if there is considerable tissue loss, the epithelium prong may not enter into the middle. So there can be total fibrosis, no skin regeneration. That is possible. So you have seen sometimes there will be scar marks where there will be no skin formation, that is totally separate from the scar. It may be possible, but if you can oppose the margins close together, then it is possible also that the skin can restore. This is number one. Number two, whenever there is so much loss, the blood clot, the granulation tissue, etc. cannot fill it up. So what it will do? So the cells will contract. So that is known as wound contraction. As a result of wound contraction, the wound becomes smaller and smaller. Little amount of wound contraction is possible during the also first intention, but it is usually not required because the margins are already closed. But wound contraction is very important in healing by second intention. Choto belay tore ja injury gulo chilo seigulo dekh aste aste aro choto hoye jabe jodi boro karu mark. This is because the process of contraction will go on and remodelings go on. So wound contraction. Third thing is there will be more amount of hemorrhage. Fourth thing is there will be much more amount of granulation tissue formation. So the fibrosis will be also more. And what about the wound strength? Much the fibrosis, much the loss, less will be the strength. So the wound strength will be less in case of healing by second intention. So healing by first intention occurs when there is a clean cut, non-infected healing. Healing by second intention occurs when it is a lacerated and also infected injury. So differences are that there can be actual skin loss to so much amount that skin restoration may not be possible. There will be much more hemorrhage, much more granulation tissue formation. There will be considerable wound contraction, and there will be also, it will take much more time, and as a result of infection, it will take much more time to heal. There will be more fibrosis, but ultimately the wound strength will be less. Okay? Now what are the factors for proper wound healing? Factors. So first thing is that type of injury. Had it been a clean cut injury with less tissue loss, then it will heal better. So type of injury. Now, number one. Number two, acquisition of the margins. The more close the margins will come, the better it will be. And that is the basis of doing suture. Why we are doing suture? We may give the token and we will cover it because physically there is a healing. But if we keep the margins together, then the healing will be much more easier. So, acquisition. So, margin acquisition is very much important. Number three, movement. So, whenever you oppose these margins, if there will be any movement here, then there is a chance that if they will go away, they can go away. So, that is the movement. If any movement, and if you see that whenever any injury over a joint, like knee, like elbow, they will feel poor. That is our personal experience, isn't it? An injury over the knee joint will feel poor because there is always movement. So there will be always the margins will go through. So movement. Number four is infection. If infection is present, then it will delay the total process. So there will be delay in the healing. Number five is the status or the physique of the patient. Number five is the local vascular system. That is very much important. If it is already non-vascular. If the blood vessel vascular supply is already compromised, then there will be poor healing. So these are the local features, but there are also some systemic features. Number one is the person itself, his constitution or her constitution. If she or he is very much frail, weak, suffering from any debilitating disease, old age, then in those cases healing will be poor. Because a heal, a wound in a child, children will heal better. They have the more power of regeneration and repair. In an older age group, we will also lose this thing. So systemic, number one is the constitution of the patient. Number two, diabetes mellitus. Metabolic disorders like diabetes mellitus. If it is present, it will prone to, it will cause infection, it will cause more vascular damage to the area. Number three, general circulatory status. If the patient is having any bad heart, already his or her circulation is falling, in that case, there will be problems. Sorry, one minute. So in that case, it will cause problem. So these are the systemic factors and also nutrition of the patient. Because vitamin C, zinc, these are very bad also in amino acids. These are very, very important in case of healing. Vitamin C is very important for structural organization of the collagen material. And you will already know. So if these are deficient, then there will be also tissue loss and tissue injury. You know that scarring. In scarring, there is always bleeding, vitamin C deficiency, and that is occurring as a result of abnormal collagen deposition. So abnormal collagen formation will give rise to this. So these are the factors which are important. Now what are the complications? Complications are wound healing, non-healing, they cannot heal properly, delayed healing, there will be formation of less granulation tissue. Like there can be burst abdomen. You see in the words, a lot of stitches will go burst because less granulation tissue is formed, so they cannot hold the stitches, so it will burst open. The again there can be also formation of more granulation tissue. So granulation tissue. From the wound margin can pop out. So there is formation of exuberant granulation tissue. And that will again cause healing problem because the margins will not come together. And late complications are, there can be a hypertrophic scar. A bad hypertrophic elevated scar is sometimes present over an ugly accident. Then we have, some of us have these things. And there can be, these hypertrophic scar can go on sometimes proliferating for life with formation of itching there, with appearance of itching. These are known as keloids. So keloids occur as a result of abnormality in the healing when there will be excessive collagenization, and first there will be a formation of a hypertrophic scar which is confined to the margin of the wound. Later on it will become, it's much more increased, it will approach outside the margin of the wound, and so like a crab that is extending its claws, and there will be also intense itching. So this is keloid and it needs treatment. Very rarely squamous cell carcinoma can appear from a chronic non-healing wound, but that is a very very rare complication. Okay, so this is in short all about healing. Thank you very much.